in the beginning of time, there was nothing, and from that nothingness emerged creation. The creation was initiated just by the primordial sound. From this all-pervading resonance emerged space, air, fire, water, and earth. The five elements form the fundamental basis for all physical manifestations. The cosmos was filled with galaxies and stars. In our solar system, orbiting around the sun, came planets and moons of different sizes. Only one of the planets had an atmosphere, which made the air suitable for existence of life. This planet we call Earth, our Earth. On its surface rose hills and mountains. From those peaks flowed rivers and lakes, which led to large oceans of water. Then, life came in the form of fish, plants, animals, birds, and finally, man.
In the scheme of natural evolution, a unique and rare paradigm shift takes place when God Himself decides to incarnate. After perhaps several yugas, the cosmic director decides to enter the stage of world and perform his leelas as the divine actor. As has been the divine legacy, the Lord has time and again incarnated in this Pavana Bhumi of Bharat, the sacred land of India. This time, the mankind has been blessed profusely with unprecedented grace of the Paripurna Avatar, Bhagawan Sri Satya Sai Baba, who blessed the most fortunate Raju family in the remote hamlet of Puttaparthi by taking birth as Satyanarayana Raju. The musical instruments started playing on their own as if announcing the divine arrival. Even as a young toddler, the little Satya taught everyone the importance of Sankirtanam, singing the glory of the Lord. He started the Pandari Bhajan group along with his playmates, who even as tiny tots inspired the feeling of devotion in the hearts of elders of the village. On one occasion, Puttaparthi was hit by an epidemic of cholera, and guess who rescued the people from this terrible infliction? It was none other than the Pandari Bhajan group. In fact, the very first message of Satya, also lovingly known as Swami by his devotees, was in the form of a bhajan. Manasa bhajare Guru Charanam. O mind, dwell on the sacred feet of your master.
Manasa bhajare Guru Charanam. Dustarabhama sagara taranam.
Over the years, Swami composed several bhajans from Namavali, which is nothing but a string of God's different names, to songs with deep inspiring message of transformation. Swami has always had a special corner in his heart for the singing saints like Tyagaraja, Purandara Dasa, Mirabai, to name a few. The timeless yearning of a devotee for the Lord has been beautifully captured in the compositions of these great singing saints. It is said, talent is God's gift. But what you do with that talent is your gift back to God. Swami has always encouraged the musicians from different genre and style to express their love and gratitude to the Supreme One in the form of devotional music. It is a sight to witness, even for the angels in the heaven, when the Creator Himself enjoys His creation, expressing His unconditional love and bliss. Swami has time and again emphasized that music has the unique capacity to induce bhakti bhava, the feeling of devotion, not only within the singer, but also in the hearts of the listeners. To foster the noble means of spreading bhakti to the masses in this Kali Yuga, and to tap the perennial fountain of fine arts from our ancient classical heritage. On 20th November, the year 2000, Swami inaugurated the Satya Sai Mirpuri College of Music at Prashanti Nilayam. Right from the initial stage, Swami used to frequently visit the music college to encourage the students and staff, guiding and nurturing their talents in every step.
Thank you.
the divine connoisseur of music, has perfectly placed both the genres of Indian classical music, the Carnatic and the Hindustani. If Karma Marga is like a bullock cart, Jnana Marga is like a car, then Bhakti Marga is like an aeroplane. Music is synonymous and inseparable from the path of Bhakti. As Swami has so lovingly assured us, music is the surest, easiest, and fastest way to reach God.